were a man of distinction, a real big spender. Good looking, so refined. Hey, wouldn't you like to know what's going on in my mind? So let me get right to the point.
Well, I knew I wanted to get away from home. You know, I never saw a musical before I was in one. After I'd been dancing professionally for a couple of years, that's when I decided to really become a dancer. Well, I studied with Anthony Tudor when I danced at the Met. He gave a two-hour class from 10 to 12 every morning, and then we rehearsed all day, and then we did the opera at night, and for all of that, we got $80 a week. Flossie said, a dancer who's not an actor is just so much animated wallpaper. You did a little movement with your hip or something. But see, you're not just doing that. You are thinking, look at this. And all of a sudden, the whole face changes. There's something going on in your head. Otherwise, it's just like a can of worms. Watching, you know, people moving around doesn't mean anything. It's got to be you're expressing the music, you're expressing the feeling of the story. And when you see a number that Fosse did compared to a number that somebody else did, the Fosse number jumps off the stage because he had everybody thinking something on every single step. You were very busy when you were in a Fosse show. You worked, and it was very satisfying. You were very proud to be a Fosse dancer and to be in that show, even just in the chorus. When the day that Fosse died, which was the opening night of Sweet Charity in Washington, D.C., he sat down with the dancers after the very last rehearsal about how you can't compete with anybody else. You just have to compete with your own best self. You're not competing with anybody else. And he told people to really save their money. Don't just fritter it away. And I mean, he was talking to this company like a Dutch uncle. And I think somewhere he must have known. He walked out of that rehearsal and died on the street. The thing that's so wonderful about Luigi is that he really dances to the music. And so many people just do calisthenics to the music, and it doesn't have any feeling of what the music is trying to express. If you marry somebody at 20 and you're still married to them when you're 70, it doesn't say much for your growth. I wanted a different kind of man every 10 years. Completely different kind of man. We do change. At first I was definitely had to have somebody in show business, and then I had to have somebody that was my Howard was a psychologist. I thought, boy, that'll straighten me out. Then I thought, no, I have to marry somebody with money. And so I married a businessman the third time. None of it worked, darling. My one and only child.
Your one and only, right? Yeah.
I had a career from the time I was 17 till I was 31, and then I had her. It changes everything, but it's definitely worth it. You're really a choice how you want to feel about people. In any instant of the moment of now, you have like a vertical line, and there's this choice, this choice, this choice, this choice. And whatever you're feeling to people that are around you, they can sense it. If you're being very loving and hopeful, and then that's going to mirror back. And if you're in a show, don't ever mark. Don't mark, because if you're the one that's dancing full out every time, they'll notice you.
One moment, please. An 88-year-old man needs a little more time than most of us to get started in the morning. Good morning, Mr. Pinchley. He's coming around. That's it, Mr. Pinchley. Come on. Come on, get those lips moving. He's all right now. He has another 2 hours before he goes under again. I'll be back at 12. Goodbye, Mr. Pinchley.
Irby Fitz has been on. And I'm in rather a hurry. I must die to be shy. I'm fickle. Ipswich, England's me own. I married something called Emma. One night I chanced to roam and roamed into a dilemma. Give me the twitch, the witch which I ditch, oh, it's a rock in the head. What a petunia. Though I can't lose the itch, for that witch in Ipswich. The witch which I wed is richer than the witch to which I'm led. Now look at me, fix you down on a stitch. Don't switch to the witch who I give you the twitch, which witch is not rich as the witch you wed instead. Crawl into your niche and hide Mrs. Fitch to bed. In my head when it twists, time is war. It's a sort of a trade-off, you might say.
Though I can't lose the itch, that which is